Marcus Theaters IMAX with the Dream Lounger. Gonna watch the new Journey to Mount Sinai movie.
It's gonna be like, what? I drove all the way here down to watch it? How dare you?
Patterns of Evidence, Journey to Buddha. I thought it was Journey to Mount Sinai, but I guess it ain't. I guess it's Journey to Buddha. Dang, they serve beer and wine in this theater. I wasn't expecting that. I wonder if it's made out of water. Water into wine. So this is the inside of this cool theater that plays the Mount Sinai movie. E franchise, e Pepsi Cola.
E Pepsi Cola.
IMAX, UMAX, we all max for the IMAX. Oh wait, it's not in there. It's over here in the little theater. Okay, these are the seats in this amazing theater. Look at this. These seats have this reclining feature. Look at this, look at this. Leather reclining seats. That's so cool.
I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
Gonna watch a documentary about Mount Sinai. Probably shouldn't quit my day job. Those are the first four films. That's a fifth film. And yeah, there's number one. I can turn off the flash here probably. This remarkable pattern of evidence began to emerge earlier in Egyptian history than most. Oh, I missed it. That's the second film. What would Moses have used to write the first books of the Bible? Alright, I think I'm gonna shut up.
Everything. He truly loves me.
So Curtis, what did you think of the movie? Was it good?
It was spontaneous, excellent.
What are you talking about? It hasn't started yet.
It was a grieva ascosta mobulta.
This is a preview to The Journey Home.
It was a super.
Have you seen The Journey Home yet?
No.
So how do you explain?
Hello, I'm Tim Mahoney, and again, thank you for watching this film, Patterns of Evidence. And we have an exciting panel that we're going to be sharing with you today. They all love the Bible.
That's pretty good. What'd you think? Well, all right. Just got done watching the Mount Sinai movie. Patterns of Evidence, Journey to Mount Sinai. Part one. This is just the first part. There's going to come a second part pretty soon. Probably early 2023, probably January or February. They're going to have a part two. So this is really Journey to Mount Sinai part one is what it is. And so basically, I think the way I could describe it is that part one is really just disproving the wrong locations. They really spent pretty much the whole movie disproving the traditional Mount Sinai and disproving a few other mountains that some people have proposed. They didn't really talk about Jebel al-Waz all that much. So I think it's really going to be the second film that's going to come out in early 2023. And that's going to be the film that really shows how the correct location of Mount Sinai in Saudi Arabia at Jebel al-Waz, that's the one that's going to match all of the criteria. These other locations don't match all the criteria, or they match some of the criteria, but it just doesn't fit very well. And so it's really going to be the next film that's really going to prove that Jabal al-Laws over in Saudi Arabia is the correct Mount Sinai. And so I think that's going to be the film where they're really going to show the evidence, because they didn't really show a lot of the correct mountain in this film. They showed a little bit, but they didn't really show much. They didn't talk about the split rock that much. They didn't have much of Jim and Penny Caldwell, and barely had any of them, really. And so I think it's really the next film. I think that's going to be the one that I'm really going to look forward to. But, I mean, this one was still good, you know. It's still good to listen to all of the arguments coming from the people who hold to the traditional Mount Sinai. It's good to hear from them why they believe what they believe. And I love the way that Tim Mahoney just lets them speak for themselves and just makes it so blatantly clear that they're wrong. Even though he's not like yelling at them and saying, you're wrong. He's not doing that. He's just letting you see the evidence for yourself. And it starts to become pretty blatantly clear that they're wrong, you know. I love the part where he said, well, why would Moses be tending his flocks in the Sinai Peninsula when he was living in Midian? You know, it's a long way. It's like 400 miles to walk all the way around the Gulf of Aqaba. And David Roll says, well, you know, they had boats. Maybe Moses took his sheep on some boats and crossed the Gulf of Aqaba. And it's just like, really? Moses put his sheep on the boats and then went over to Mount Sinai? It's just like, what? No, he was tending his flocks in Midian, on the backside of the desert in Midian. And so I just love the way that Tim Mahoney just lets the evidence speak for itself and makes it crystal clear that the traditional Mount Sinai and all these other ones proposed don't fit or match the description that is found in the Bible. It just doesn't fit the description at all. But it's really going to be the next film that's going to show the proof and the evidence that the true Mount Sinai, Jabal al-Laws over in Saudi Arabia, that's the mountain that is the correct mountain. They're going to show how it matches all the criteria. So it's really the next film that I'm going to look forward to. But it's still a good movie, and it's still playing on Tuesday night, so you should go watch it if you want. Watch the first four first, though. So that's it.